another real fantastic trait, and that is Brad Erickson. Erickson. This is his third time at the Truth and Illusion Show. Give him a big round of applause.
Thank you. Can you hear me okay with this? I want to make sure this is on. Oh, one place. All right. This is my third time to this Truth and Illusion Show. How many of you guys, this is your first time, raise your hand. Okay? And how many have never been to one of these shows, raise your hand. Not the same thing. All right, let's do a little activity, because you guys have been sitting a while. If you are willing to, stand up with me, or stand up with me if you're willing to. All right? We're going to do a little game, all right? This game goes like this. Every time my hands cross, you clap your hands. If my hands do not cross and you clap your hands, you are out. Fair enough? Let's try this. Ready? Oh, you just clap your hands the normal way. I do this, you do this. Okay, ready? Oh, that's good. Ooh, good. I'll give you a chance. I'll give you a chance, all right? No more chances after this. Watch your can over there. One, two. One, two. Good job. I'm a magician, so today I'm going to magish. I'm also a wizard. No, we're not going to do that. We're not going to do that. You guys didn't get that joke? Wizard's going to whiz? How many guys, how many children are here tonight? Can you hear me hear the children clap? No children! Let me hear the children clap! Are you an adult? Are you an old man? All right. When I was a child, I would like to tell you about my first magic show ever. I was so excited. I made my own little magic show box out of cardboard. And in our backyard, we put up 15 folding chairs, and we had a little audience from the neighborhood, and we had about 14 or 15 people eating triangle sandwiches and chips. And I put on a little magic show for them. Would you like to see what I did?
Yes.
All right, so. These are not the size on the cards, but to illustrate that my hands were small and the cards were big, I will use bigger cards today. So I had one, two, three, four, and five cards. And I took one of the cards and I threw it into the box, and I snapped my fingers, and magically I had one, two, three, four, five cards. Everyone put their fist in the air and said, amazing!
Amazing!
That was pretty good. You weren't ready for that. You know, we're gonna give you guys another chance, all right? You guys another chance? All right. So, I was actually 6 years old. I did my first magic show, and I had one, two, three, four, five cards, and I took out not one, but two cards, and I snapped my fingers, and all of a sudden I had one, two, three, four, five cards, and everyone put their hands in the air and said, amazing! That's better. Give you one more chance. I was 2 years old. There were 500 people in my backyard eating triangle sandwiches and chips, and I put on a little show. My hands were small, the cards were big, and I had five cards. One, two, three, four, five, and I took out one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine cards. I snapped my fingers and there were still one, two, three, four, five cards. They all disappeared and the audience said, but for me, childhood is a time of innocence and joy. But something happens along the way. And we're going to talk about that. So I know a lot of adults that are not so happy. What happened along the way? We're going to talk about that fact, all right? So I have this here cover. This represents our heart. Many of us, our heart starts out full of joy and it's vibrant. But something happens along the way. Somebody says that, you know, I think you're stupid, right? And that breaks your heart. Later on, you have a best friend, and your best friend leaves you because he found another better best friend than you. And it happened in my case. When I had my first girlfriend, I thought, this is the woman I'm going to marry. And 3 weeks later, she broke up with me. And your heart is left broken, right? And you can go through all kinds of things, abuse, divorce, you name it. There are many ways that our heart gets broken. And what happens when our heart gets broken is we don't want everybody to see what we are inside. We hide ourselves. So I don't want people to know that I'm an empty shell of a human being and I have absolutely nothing to offer anybody. I've got a little song that actually goes with that subject here. I'm going to sing for you.
He'll heal your secret scars. Not the message behind what we were saying, but the way we did it. Trickery, tomfoolery. We're just a bunch of tricksters having some fun. A little sleight of hand, a little misdirection. We didn't do any miracles at all. But there is one who does miracles, and that's Jesus Christ, God in the human flesh. The M, the I, the R, the A, the C, the L, the E. Just a word until God gets a hold of your heart and does a miracle. What I'm going to do is I'm going to mix these cards up. I need seven volunteers. Seven numbers. Seven cards. And you don't have to get up. I just need you to stand up. If you want to help, seven people, just stand up, I'll see you. Stand up, it makes it easier. All right, right there, tell me a number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7.
Four.
1, 2, 3, 4. All right, go ahead and sit down. Go ahead, ladies, stand up, I'll get there. Give me another number. One, right there. All right, go ahead and sit down. Yes, right next to you.
Five.
Five. Right there. All right. Anybody else brave it? Yes. Two. Right there, number two. All right, anybody else? Right there.
Three.
Three. 1, 2, 3. That leaves six and seven.
Seven.
Seven. All right, that leaves one. I need one more volunteer, right there. Now, stand up. You think this is difficult, right? Because you only, but you see, since you're the last one, you can tell me to put this in six, or you can switch any number with that. You want to put it in six, all right. But you have your opportunity right there. We started with miracle. We gave you illusions. But we pointed you to the one who can do a miracle in your life. Whether you're broken because of COVID, whether your job is in shambles, your relationship is in shambles, whether your faith in God is shaken, whether you don't even know who God is. God is in the reclamation business. God wants to reclaim you and make something out of your life. And the way he did that was to die on a cross. An instrument of death, the painting you saw, very agonizing, but he took your place, the penalty we deserve for our sins, and he took it upon himself. And while we were yet sinners, the Bible tells us, Christ died for us. No longer a miracle, because it's God. See, God is in the reclamation business. God wants to reclaim you and build a relationship with you. Tonight, the magicians, the tricksters will be down here to talk to any of you who want to share and know what it means to follow Jesus Christ. If you have questions, several of us are pastors. All of us know Jesus as Lord and Savior. Any one of us could help you out. The pastor of this church could also help you out to know without a shadow of a doubt that your sins are forgiven and that you're in a new direction. By the way, your reclamation project may not happen overnight because God will take some time and do it right. Will you bow with me as we pray? Father God, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for this opportunity to have fun and for the fact that you built that into each one of us, an enjoyable time. But Father, we pray that somebody tonight would say yes to Jesus. As easy as ABCs, admit that you're a sinner, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and commit everything you are and have and will be to Jesus, and let him remold you and reclaim you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We want to thank you for coming. We want to thank this church for hosting us.
Yeah.
And Lord willing, we invite you to come back next year for the Faith and Illusion Show. God bless you. Amen. Yes, I will, as soon as the performers come on down. We said the performers would be here.
They're here, in the back.
The ones that are here. All right. Here they come.
Here they come.
All right. Will you stand? Let's go out in prayer. Father God, we thank you for you made heaven and earth. Everything is in your sovereign hand, and we thank you and praise you for that. You have given us free will by that sovereignty that we might choose to follow you. Father, we pray that we would be glad in heart to remember that you did not remain on the cross, that you reclaimed the sinners, that you are a friend of the wounded heart. We give you praise for that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Go forth in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.